Talk about, you know, getting nauseous from found video, right? I mean, you're getting nauseous from these swings and tone of this show.
Can we go back to armadillo licking? That's where my intelligent levels lie.
Well, thankfully, I have enough pills in the medicine cabinet to handle all of our swings.
Well,
over
we can go back to the villain thing.
Yeah, please.
All right, let's do that. Yeah, as a matter of fact, that's where this Godzilla thing led to. Yeah. Actually, you led us into the found footage with Cloverfield.
Yeah, but I said I hated it. I didn't want to go into detail why.
But you brought it up.
Yeah, you brought it up.
Shut up, Nurse Misery. Yeah, yeah.
All right, let's go to something. All right, let's just the clown is getting irate. He's squirming in his seat, kind of like a
give
basket
him
of snakes.
To vent about.
Yes, let's give him something to. Yeah.
Throw all the right. dog a bone.
Villains.
All right.
Villains who find favor in the eyes of Chuckles the Evil Clown.
I just gave you two of them.
Godzilla.
Yep.
Right.
Yep. And there's going to be some people throwing stuff at me, but I like Disney's Captain Hook. One of my favorites.
All right, I'm not laughing at that yet. Explain.
Well, he's a pirate. The guy is pretty cool. He's one of the villains that I grew up watching, so I like watching him, except for I didn't like the musical that Christopher Walken did where he was playing Hook. That was pretty bad.
Now, that was a stage musical, Hook?
Yeah, that was really bad.
Is that what the thing? Now, Steven Spielberg made a movie called Hook, too. Is that same show? Or?
No, Christopher Walken was in the, it was over this past holiday season that Channel 10 aired a live Peter Pan.
Okay.
Half the time, Christopher Walken wasn't even singing. He was, like, reciting poetry.
Which is probably merciful.
Yeah, well, I mean, and when he did sing, it was bad.
Well, that's why he was. Yeah.
That's why he was just eloquently speaking. It was easier.
But I always liked Hook. He was a pirate. He was, you know, getting eaten by alligators, and yet he's still going around trying to kill Peter Pan.
Right,
you know,
he was
cool.
Right, he chased Peter Pan, and the alligator chased him, if I remember correctly.
Yep. Yeah, that was always good stuff. And even Spielberg's Hook, I liked that one as well. I did enjoy watching Tim Curry play the pirate character.
I kind of liked that movie. I liked it part of the way. I mean, I kind of like the idea of, because in that, if I remember correctly, that was when everybody from Disney's Peter Pan grew up, right? And kind of forgot who they were.
Yeah, Peter had grown up.
Right, and forgot who he was. Right?
Right.
But then Captain Hook hasn't, or he comes, how?
Hook never left Neverland, so he stayed the same age. Peter left Neverland and grew up. And then came back to Neverland.
Yeah, see, I really like that storyline. But then, if I remember correctly, and it's been a long time since I saw this, how they wrapped it up, I remember not liking. I can't remember why, but I mean, I liked the premise of the movie a lot, but then what they did with it, I wasn't so crazy with.
It's been a while for me as well. I don't remember how it ended.
Yeah, all I know is I enjoyed that. I enjoy, when you look deep into the Peter Pan story and see what it really is about, by the way, folks out there.
What is it really about?
You don't know?
See, when it came to Disney, I graduated from the kids' movies early. You know, by the time I was 8 years old, I was reading H.P. Lovecraft. And in other words, which was an accident, by the way, my mother bought me an H.P. Lovecraft book because she read an article in the Providence Journal about Lovecraft, a local writer, local culture, blah, blah, blah. She didn't know that Lovecraft wrote about, you know, people having sex with amphibians. So I was corrupted. I've become what I am today because of an accident on the part of my mother. She didn't finish reading the article.
Thank goodness for happy accidents.
Absolutely. But my point is that unlike a lot of, you know, so I didn't go through the usual kid thing, you know what I'm saying, of all the Disney movies. So, yeah, you're going to have to, I know the general idea of it. Neverland is where kids don't grow up. I know that.
Right. It's not where kids grow up. And keep in mind, a lot of Disney's tales that they come from, they come from a very dark story background. And they adapt them into
dust on them.
It to being child friendly. But Peter Pan, think of it, a place where you never grow up.
I like
he takes
idea.
You from your bed at night.
Takes you from your bed at night, okay. And you go back. You cannot leave.
So it's not
and
voluntary.
You never grow up.
In other words, you're stolen.
You think of it. Who would come to get you and pull you to a realm where you would not grow up?
Peter Pan's the children's Grim Reaper.
The Grim Reaper, death.
Yes. That is
Thank
the
you,
whole
yeah, okay. I'm,
story
see,
behind.
I'm having a hard time like zoning into this alternate Peter Pan reality. See, even though I never really saw the Disney movie, I still, know what I'm saying? When you say Peter Pan, I know of the story too much. That's why you're going to have to.
That is the whole story behind Peter Pan. Peter Pan is the Grim Reaper taking the children back
to Neverland,
where they can never grow up.
But
they're
they can
dead.
Be happy and play and not really
they're
know it.
They're orphans. You know, they float from a window to Neverland.
So it's a metaphor for death. Yeah.
Yes. And a lot of people don't see that. They just see the happy-go-lucky stuff. But when you go back into Disney's... And people just say they hate Disney, by the way, until you grow up, there's something wrong with you.
Yeah, there is something wrong with you because I watched the Disney movies. You know, I went back to them when I got older. And no, there's a lot to like in those Disney movies.
And when you go into their darker side, you enjoy it even more to see how they turn it into a child's story. But then you get to thinking about, whoa.
Well, it takes a twisted person to take such a dark story and shine a little fairy dust on it, make it kid friendly.
Right, make it kid friendly enough.
But the parents still understand the underlying premise.
Yeah, I think, and I'll tell you, and having watched it, I'm thinking of the movie Bambi. There was a prevailing, and yes, there was the cute little animals. Like, don't worry, my listeners, don't. I'm not losing my mind here. Yes, there was a bunch of cute little animals.
It was some tragedy, though.
In that movie had such a prevailing feeling of menace. Mm. You know, with Bambi's mother. And,
Bambi's
mother
got shot.
The
there was the fire in
right.
the forest.
I mean, that movie.
There was a lot of death and destruction.
Yeah, it was almost like a horror movie with.
For 4-year-olds.
And not just 4-year-olds. I mean, it was almost like a horror movie with comic relief.
Yeah.
Another, you know, Disney set out to make this scary, ominous, menacing movie. But then just kind of like putting the sugar with the medicine to get you to swallow it, he put the cute little animals in there just so. It'd be marketable.
Exactly.
And yeah, so I know exactly what you're saying. Yeah.
What do you expect from a guy that was sent a letter of congratulations to Adolf Hitler when he freaking conquered France?
Seriously.
Hello? Seriously.
Yeah.
He sent a letter of congratulations.
I'll tell you, I do a lot of fiction on this show, but sometimes reality is pretty fun too. Yeah. Walt Disney sent a letter of congratulations to Hitler upon conquering France.
Yeah. Yes.
So maybe, I mean... All right, so when they sent all those little French Jewish kids to the ovens, maybe, you know, Disney's sending the little kids by way of the Grim Reaper to Neverland?
Hey, who knows? Who knows what he was thinking? All I'm saying is the guy liked what he was seeing.
Well, apparently.
There was that whole scene in Peter Pan with the medicine that they all had to take just before they went off to bed to Neverland, so the kids could have died in
their
sleep.
I'll tell you, next time I feel like watching a horror movie, which will be soon, I think I'm going to, you know, Netflix a little bit of Disney, you know, rather than, I'll tell you. All right, let's, we're getting close to the end of time here, at least for the end of time for the show. Yeah, let's go with some Blue Oyster Cult. Here's a little ominous sounding thing called Then Came the Last Days of May on the Haunted Cabaret, Rhode Island Free Radio.
Thank you. All right, that was Blue Oyster Cult. Then came The Last Days of May, and then came the last 2 minutes of this episode of The Haunted Cabaret. Okay, we're going to get out of here. I want to jam in one more song at the end, so we'll see you all next episode. Thank you, Chuckles the Clown, Tony, Nurse Misery. Okay, let's do some Ramones really quick. Give you the mental level of the show we've been operating on here. Teenage Lobotomy on Rhode Island Free Radio, nighty night.